We are going to write our first test script using Protractor API. And also, we will understand what is conf.js and what is spec.js. Now, first thing first, we have to do the installation that we have already discussed in our first video in this series. So I'm going to skip this part. After that, here it says that we have to do the webdriver-manager update. Now, let us understand why this is very important. So assume that we have written our test script and we have executed it. Now, the script is going to communicate with the browser, or precisely, I can say the API is going to communicate with our browser. But there is no way which can communicate with the API and the browser directly. So in that scenario, the drivers comes into the picture. Now, each and every browser has its own driver. For example, Google Chrome has its own Google driver, I mean Chrome driver, through which it can do the communication. And for Firefox, we have Gecko driver, which is provided by the Mozilla. Now, if I go to this reference, and if you see this, how it works, here it clearly says that our test script communicates with the Selenium server, and then it communicates with the browser. Now, no need to worry about the Selenium server as of now. We will discuss that in detail in the later on videos. And here we can see that our test script is going to communicate with our browser using the browser driver. And the browser driver and the API, the communication happens by the JSON wire protocol. Now, do not worry about this protocol and how does the communication internally works. Maybe we'll see in detail about it in another video. As of now, understand that to execute our script needs to communicate with the browser. And to do the communication between the scripts and the browser, we need a driver, right? Now, if I Google Chrome driver download, I will land this page where I can see that it has some versions. Now, go to your browser menu and click on Help and then click on About Google Chrome. Here, you can see the version number, right? Now, focus only on the major version. Do not worry about the minor versions. So, here we can download our driver. But in Protractor, we no need to go and download the driver. Rather, we can use this command webdriver-manager-update, which is going to download the drivers for us as well as the Selenium standalone file that is going to act as a Selenium server. Okay, now let me show you that quickly. So here I'm going to open my terminal, so Control J, and here I'm going to just copy paste this. So copy and let me paste here. Okay, now this is going to download all the necessary files to do the execution. Okay, so it's done already. So here we can see that it's downloaded the Gecko driver, which is for Firefox, and it downloaded the Chrome driver, which is for our Chrome browser. And also it's downloaded the Selenium standalone jar file. And if you see here, it's using the version 3.141.59, which is the last version of Selenium in 3. Okay, so we are done with our installation. I mean the installation downloads of the driver and the standalone file. Now here we can see that they are given a sample test case to execute. Okay, so I'm just going to copy this, and it also says that it should be in the spec.js. Now we'll discuss what is spec in a moment. So within the first script folder, I'm going to create a JavaScript file here, so spec.js. Now in this Protractor series, we are going to execute all our test script using TypeScript, but before that we will learn how to do in JavaScript. Okay, so here I'm going to copy the snippets and paste it over here. Now if you know already Selenium with Java, and if you have used TestNG, then it is going to be very easy for you to understand. But if you don't know Selenium or TestNG or the Java part, do not worry about it. We will talk about in detail, but as this is our first script, I'm just going to give you a quick introduction about Jasmine. Now, Jasmine is a JavaScript testing framework. Actually, it is a BDD framework. So in terms of BDD, we have to write our spec file. That is what we are going to execute. And to do the executions, we have to maintain a runner file. That is nothing but our conf.js. Okay. So here we can see this. It says that we need a conf.js, and within that we have to paste this, right? So I'm going to copy this, and here I'm going to create a new file, which is conf.js, and within this I'm going to paste everything. Now let us understand what is there. Okay, so it says that we are going to use the framework which is Jasmine. Yes, we are going to use the Jasmine as our execution framework. And then it says that specs is a keyword which accept a array value. Now within the array value we have to pass our test case file name. Okay, so here we have the spec.js, and here we have passed that, right? Now here it says that Selenium address. So to communicate with the browser, we need to set up the Selenium server, but that is not needed actually. We can comment that, then we can use something called direct connect. Okay, so direct connect colon true. Okay, now we need the Selenium server address, of course, but not for Chrome or the Firefox, because Protractor API can communicate with the Chrome and Firefox without any server. Okay, so we'll talk about this in later, so do not worry about this as of now. As of now, you can use this direct connect, which means it is going to communicate with the browser using the driver which just we downloaded using the webdriver-manager update command, right? Now this is very simple. So here we have this exports.config where we are using the framework as Jasmine, and direct connect equal to true, and specs equal to we are passing the spec name. Now we know that this is object data type, right? So we have already discussed about this in our JavaScript tutorial, right? So this is going to be very simple. Now let us see the spec file. Now here we have this described. Now described is something like, I can say in testng it is like suit level, so it can have multiple tests within the describe block. Now it is nothing but it's a actual test case. Okay, this is like you are describing what is your test is going to do, whereas this it block is describing your actual functionality testing, right? Now no need to do the expect here, so let me comment this line as well. So as of now we have this browser.get, okay, which is going to load our this URL. Okay, now browser is like a global object through which we can execute our code. Okay, for example, in Selenium we have to create the driver object, right? So Chrome driver equal to new Chrome driver, through which the driver we can do the communication. I mean, we can use other methods to do the execution, right? But whereas in Protractor, browser is a global object, and in terms of JavaScript, we no need to create any object or anything. By default, it is going to create the object and it is going to use. Let us execute and see the result. So here I'm going to use the Ctrl J to bring up my terminal, and then I'm going to navigate within the first script folder, right? So cd first script. And then I have to use the command protractor to call our protractor API, and then we have to use the conf.js. okay, that is my configuration file. Now the configuration file is going to check for the spec file, and within the array we have given the spec file name, right? So here it will come, it will check for the spec file, and it will go to the spec file, and it will check for the describe block and the it block. Okay, now you have noticed that it was very quick, right? The browser has been launched and also it has been closed by itself. So in Protractor, whenever we are going to launch our script, it will automatically close the browser instance as well. Now it is very fast, so I'm just going to add a sleep here. So browser.sleep. So here I can say browser.sleep for maybe 5 seconds. Okay, so we have to give in terms of milliseconds. Now let's run again. So Ctrl L to clear, and then let me run the same command here. Now it is going to launch our browser, and it is going to wait for 5 seconds, then the browser is going to get closed. Okay, so yes, so now the script has been executed completely, right? Now let's quickly recap. So here we have a spec file which is nothing but your actual test script file. Okay, and we have this config.js, conf.js file, which tells that what framework you are using. So by default, Protractor supports Jasmine. Other than Jasmine, we have Mocha and Karma as well, but I think we are going to stick with the Jasmine for our entire series. And then we have to use this direct connect, which means that we no need to start our Selenium server to communicate between the browsers. Now, this is very important to start the Selenium server if you are going to run for other browsers like Microsoft Edge or the Chromium Edge or the Opera browser. To execute in Chrome or Firefox, we can use this direct connect directly. Okay. Now here we have this specs, which is going to accept an array, and within the array we have to pass our test script file name. Okay, so this is just spec.js, right? Now within the spec file we have describe block, which is like your suit level, which can hold lot of test cases. Now this it block is like your single test. Okay, so I can have multiple tests as well, so I can copy and paste. So if I run this now, it is going to execute for two times. I mean, within the same browser, it is going to run the it blocks twice. Okay, so we'll see that in detail in upcoming videos. As of now, I think this is pretty much enough, right? Now also you have noticed that when I started to write like browser.sleep, it's not giving any suggestion, right? By default, you want any suggestions when you are going to use the JavaScript file, but when you are going to use the TypeScript, it will give all you suggestion. But as of now, we can do the workaround. So here I'm going to import the browser object from the Protractor API. So here I'm going to say const, and then I can say maybe driver equal to require. So require in the sense we are going to import that, right? So here I'm going to say within double quotes protractor. Okay, so protractor. Yes. Now here what can I do is, here I can use this driver objects. Okay, so driver dot browser, I can say dot sleep. See, now we are getting all the methods suggestions in VS Code, as well as it gives the documentation like what this methods it is actually doing, right? So in this way we can use our VS Code to give the suggestions. But even if you use this or we don't use this, doesn't matter, because the browser can understand the browser as a global object. So require is not necessary to use, but as a learner, when we are going to learn, obviously we need some suggestions so that we can at least know if there is any compile time error or not, right? So I think that's pretty much enough for our first test script. We'll see in detail from the next video. That's it from my side. If you like the video, please like and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next one very soon.